grace of God has reached for me and pulled me from the raging sea. And I am safe on the solid ground. The Lord is my salvation.
Since then, we have a great high priest who has passed through the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God. Let us hold fast to our confession. For we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weaknesses, but we have one who in every respect has been tested as we are, yet without sin. Let us therefore approach the throne of grace with boldness, so that we may receive mercy and find grace to help in time of need. In the days of his flesh, Jesus offered up prayers and supplications with loud cries and tears to the one who was able to save him from death. And he was heard because of his reverent submission. Although he was a son, he learned obedience through what he suffered. And having been made perfect, he became the source of eternal salvation for all who obey him.
I will not fear when darkness falls. His strength will help me scale these walls.
We are human. Every day we make choices, most of which are inconsequential. Then there are those choices we make that carry a little more weight. Many choices we make have no impact on our spiritual well-being, or so we think. We are bombarded every day with every sort of information from every possible source of information. It's so easy for anger to creep in, or judgment, or disappointment, or disgust, or unbelief, all kinds of emotions or actions that we really don't want to give in to. Paul says in Romans 7, 14 through 18, "For we know that the law is spiritual, but I am of the flesh, sold into slavery under sin. I do not understand my own actions. For I do not do what I want, but I do the very thing I hate. Now if I do what I do not want, I agree that the law is good. But in fact, it is no longer I who do it, but sin that dwells within me. For I know that the good does not dwell within me, that is, in my flesh. For the desire to do the good lies close at hand, but not the ability." Jesus, our Savior and King, was tested in every way, just as we are. So he is not unable to sympathize with our weaknesses. He is so merciful. So yes, as the scripture says, let us go before the throne of grace with boldness, so that we may receive mercy and find grace to help in time of need. A song came into my spirit as I was writing this meditation, and it strongly came into my spirit. And I hadn't heard it in so many years, actually. And the chorus goes like this: "Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy on me. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy on me.
The Lord is my salvation.
God, use Christ Jesus to be my shepherd and the Lamb of Sacrifice. Help me to embrace the mystery of salvation, the promise of life rising out of death. Help me to hear the call of Christ and give me the courage to follow it readily, that I too may lead others to you. This I ask through Jesus, my shepherd and guide. Amen.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, for by your holy cross you have redeemed the world. Amen.
My daddy.